Yesterday, we have discussed different four points of chapter number 2, polynomial. First of all, we have discussed what is polynomial. Then, we also discussed how to find out the degree of a polynomial. The highest power of a variable is known as degree of the polynomial. Then, we have also discussed types of polynomials. There are three types of polynomial on the basis of the degree. If degree is 1, then it is known as linear polynomial. If degree is 2, then it is known as quadratic polynomial. If degree is 3, then it is known as cubic polynomial. We also draw the graph of polynomial. If you draw the graph of linear polynomial, it intersects the x-axis at one point, and that's why it has maximum 1,0. While quadratic equation, it has maximum 2,0, and cubic polynomial, it has maximum 3,0s. And you know how to find out the intersection or zeros of a different polynomial. So intersection of graph with x-axis is known as zeros of polynomial. We have also solved exercise number 2.1 to find out the zeros of the polynomial. Last time also we have discussed one very important concept, and that is relation between coefficient and zeros. For linear polynomial, it has 1,0, it is denoted by alpha, and the value of alpha is equal to minus b by a. Quadratic polynomial, it has 2,0, alpha and beta, and the relation is alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a, and alpha into beta is equal to c by a. Similarly, for cubic polynomial, there are 3 zeros, alpha, beta and gamma. You also know the relation between coefficient and zero. Alpha plus beta plus gamma is equal to minus b by a. Alpha beta plus beta gamma plus alpha gamma is equal to c by a, and alpha into beta into gamma means product of 0 is equal to minus b by a. Well, let us start exercise 2.2, first example. Find zeros and verify the relation between zeros and coefficient. Once again, here you have to find out the zeros, and then you have to verify the relationship between zeros and coefficient. Let me start first example. The first example is x square minus 2x minus 8. You know it is quadratic polynomial, and your aim is to find out zeros. So first of all, polynomial equal to 0. Now you have to use 9-standard method of factorization. You can use method of trinomial. You have to factorize 8 in such a way you get minus 2. So 4 2s are 8. So x square minus 4x plus 2x minus 8 is equal to 0. If you take common from first 2 and 2 common from the second 2, x common, what you get, x minus 4 plus, here you can take 2 common, again you get x minus 4 equal to 0. So x minus 4 equal to 0 and x plus 2 equal to 0. So x is equal to 4 and x is equal to minus 2. So they are known as zeros, and that's why they are denoted by alpha and beta. So alpha is equal to 4 and beta is equal to minus 2. You know, now alpha plus beta is equal to 4 plus minus 2 is equal to 2. Alpha into beta is equal to 4 into minus 2 is equal to minus 8. Let us verify the zeros and coefficient. So alpha plus beta, you know, is equal to minus b by a. So here, in this coefficient, a is equal to 1, b is equal to minus 2, and c is equal to minus 8. X square minus 2x minus 8. So a is equal to 1, b is equal to minus 2 and c is equal to minus 8. So alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a. So minus b means again minus 2 upon a means what? 1. So you get 2. So alpha plus beta is equal to 2. According to formula also, alpha plus beta is equal to 2. Now alpha into beta, you know the formula, is equal to c by a. What about c? Is minus 8 by a means 1, so you get minus 8. So alpha into beta is equal to minus 8. So in first example, find zeros and then verify the zeros and coefficient. So alpha plus beta is equal to 2. Here also alpha plus beta is equal to 2. Here alpha into beta is equal to minus 8. Similarly, here also alpha into beta is equal to minus 8.